Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name's Bracia. If you're new, make sure to subscribe, and if you're not new, welcome back. I'm wearing my glasses because honestly, it's too fucking early. It's too fucking early in the morning, and sorry, there's like this guy next to me. There's just this guy next to me in a car. But yeah, anyways, it's really early in the morning. It's 6 a.m. So honestly, I kind of like, I'm trying to do this thing where I'm getting up at like 5, 6 o'clock in the morning and go to the gym and kind of just start my day from there. But I don't know, it's gonna get some like getting used to because my sleeping schedule, the way it's just been off. So I feel like I've been waking up late. So this is good for me because I feel like this will help me like get shit done like more throughout the day. So I hate wearing makeup at the gym. So like I just put like a concealer under my eyes. But honestly, I feel like I look crazy right now. Like, I don't know about you guys, but when I when I wake up in the morning, I feel like underneath my, I feel like my face is just fucking swollen in the morning. Like my lips and my under my eye, like just my whole face. So I'm just gonna wait till like I feel like I'm settled in. All right, anyways, guys. So let's get out of here. Okay, so I just got out of the shower. This wasn't like part of the video, but I don't, do you ever have days where you just wake up and you're just, your mood's not the best? Like you may even feel like crying and you don't even know why. But whenever I start off the day well and then I feel like there's a mood shift which is not like positive, because there's no reason for me to feel like this, but I don't know why I feel like a change of attitude. Like I just need to change my attitude. So I wanted to light some candles and maybe like sage a little. This is the sage I have. I'll show you guys up close. This is like the little, wait, hold on. I don't want to burn my little robe. Okay, so this is, anyways, but this is the sage I have. So I'm gonna burn this up. So pretty much like, I always do this whenever I feel like, I'm trying to do this every day, but it's really hard to pretty much do this every day, like take 10 minutes out of your day. Believe it or not, it is, at least for me. Just kind of, I'm honestly a little nervous about even saging because my neighbors swear it's weed and they already like snitched on me. Last time I was smoking and they said it was, I mean, no, I wasn't smoking. Last time I was saging and some lady thought it was weed and she said something. I heard her from the balcony. It was really annoying. So I'm gonna start, I don't think I can hear my music. I don't know why I'm on like a Sierra vibe. Okay, so I cut up my lemons. So this is like this is something I usually like to make like after the gym or if I'm not, like if I want like a light little snack. I don't know why, like I love it. Some of you guys may think it's gross, but I think it's so good. So pretty much first step's lemon. So I cut up some lemons. Like honestly, I'm just gonna have like one toast. So I usually cut up like three little slices or like little slices like that. And then avocado. So I'm gonna cut up the avocado. So pretty much this is like a sandwich, like a salmon sandwich dish. Yeah, I love it. I got it from YouTube like a long ass time ago and I kind of just stuck with it because it's been so good. My little sage sesh though was really nice. I feel a lot better. But what the fuck was wrong with me after the gym? Maybe I was just tired. Maybe I was just upset. I'm so proud of myself. Yesterday, I feel like I did the most in like one day than I have in like the past 2 years. It's really sad, but I was on it yesterday. I was like super productive. I was getting a lot of things done, getting things started as well. Like I was really proud of myself. So this is a good avocado. So I love a good avocado. Oh, this should wait them now. Okay, so we got our avocado, our living going. I like to like prep things up before anything, so I'm not like scrambling around. Hold on, I got it right now. I have a little sesh to myself before this. So I'm trying not to forget anything. So first step is olive oil, just a little though. That's it. And then, what's next? So we're gonna toast our bread, I'm not gonna toast it yet, but I'm gonna get it ready. Not to toast it up. First step is pretty much putting the
oil. Oh no, I found it.
Okay, so this is the salmon I'll be using today. I always get this one. I really, really like this one. I think it tastes so good. I'm gonna go ahead and open it up. I'm just gonna let that heat up because I just turned that on. I'm trying to drink like celery juice maybe like 3 times a week. So I got some celery and there's so many benefits from doing that. Let me Google. Because I know I wasn't gonna explain it right. So these are the benefits for drinking celery juice every morning. So helps flush out toxins, anti-inflammatory, supports hydration, may help with skin condition. I heard it even helps with Alzheimer's, but I don't know if that's true. I just added that in there, but I don't know. For all like acid, vitamin K. This isn't a good website, let's find something else. Okay, so celery juice is thought to clear away toxins that contribute to kidney stone formation and has long been used in traditional medications. It also helps flush out the body so you can pass the stone. Oh my god. So, you know, pretty much it helps with a lot. Okay, so I just like put that there. And then I put some, this thing's kind of already salty, so I put like a little bit of pepper sometimes. I'm gonna do this one. Sometimes I add an egg on it, and sometimes I'll put an egg. I think today I am, since I'm only going to have one toast, so I'm going to be pretty hungry. So I'm going to cut the egg on this side. This is where our lemons come in. So I like to put them like next to it. I'm gonna let that do its thing, and then I'm gonna make my egg over here. I'm gonna make like a sunny side up egg. I swear to God though, you guys, every time I make this for somebody, they're like, wow, this is like really good. I don't know if they're lying to me, but this has always been my go-to. For some reason with my egg, I don't like putting oil, I ran out of butter. So this is what I have for like, I guess, butter. With a little sprayer. I'm just gonna spray a little bit of that. Okay, so let's just start toasting our bread. So what I use is wheat bread. I usually like white bread, but since I'm trying to be like healthier. This is pretty much done, so I put it on like low heat. So you could just, I hate when it's cold. Like I like everything like fresh. I think that's why I'm moving around fast, because I don't want it to be anything to be cold. This is how I like it toasted, so this is good. So then I'm gonna get my avocado and just like start. Fucking good, I swear. You guys try it. It's literally like a couple days later from when I went to the gym. And what else did I do? Oh, I cooked my little salmon breakfast dish. That was so good. But anyways, now I'm at Harvest Dispensary. This is literally my favorite dispensary here in Phoenix, Arizona. I feel like they have the best, like just the best products here. So I always come here and it's really close by where I stay at. I had an audition yesterday and I passed and I did the second round today. They pretty much told me the same thing the last agency told me. They want me to build a resume. Like they feel like they love my presence. They love my delivery when I do the script there. But they're just like, you don't have any, you don't have a resume. Like, so I'm like, yeah, I really don't. It gave me some ideas. Like I was thinking, cause I'm going to my classes right now, but those classes aren't like, those don't build my resume. Like I need to like throw myself out there, do short films, do like do things like that so I could put it on my resume. So she actually gave me an idea. So I was thinking of going to ASU College here in Phoenix, Arizona and going to their theater class. And cause I heard they have short films and they do that. So that would that would help a lot with my resume. So that's something I was just thinking about right now. So you guys might not care, but I don't know. I'm very, very passionate about this. I know like the percentage of it, like every time I talk about this, people are like, you know what the percentage of this is? Like I do, but I really believe in myself that I really feel like I'm sure other people may be more experienced because they all tell me the same thing. They're like, there's kids who have been doing this since they were young. They have a resume, but
you have a presence, and you know, and that's something you can't buy or teach. Like that's big. So I do agree with that. I feel like I know I do. So I want to just kind of make sure the resume is like where it should be at. Make sure it's more professional when I'm going into agencies, because right now I'm kind of rusty. I feel like I'm new to all this, so I don't really know what things to properly do and how to do it. So now that I've spoken with somebody, and I don't know, like people just kind of tell you, like, I don't know how to explain it, but I'm really excited I got the advice. Even if I didn't get it, that's fine. I'm very confident that I will. So I'm like, that was a really good idea. I don't know why I didn't think about that. So I'm gonna do that. And then there's also this other website that I found out last week where Arizona has short films and where to audition, and pretty much a listing of every time they come out, like every week. And I barely found out about that. So this next month, I really plan on dedicating a majority of my time on doing short films and building my resume. I don't get paid for them, but it's fine because it's helping my resume and it's helping for the agencies, and they see like, okay, she's done a little bit of this and that. And I feel like it's good for me to do change, because every actor, like coach, has a different techniques, and I feel like it'd be nice to see what techniques like ASU has to offer when it comes to theater, and also just seeing the other students, and I don't know, just to see what they do. I think it'd be very interesting. But anyways, let me tell you what the plan is today. So the plan today is I'm going to go to the dispensary right now, and then I'm going to go to the nail salon and pick up my friend Cynthia, and then after that go eat.
Oh my god, you're Libra.
And then Bruce is always telling me like, oh, I don't like Libras.
But I've never really hung out the Libra girls, so.
Okay, that's different, because I feel like Libra Mel, and like when you get with a Libra Mel, like that's a romantic situation.
My exes were Libras.
Oh, okay. This that's why you don't like Libras.
Yeah.
But I feel like with girls, like sometimes the guy sign I can't be with, like I can't stand.
Yeah.
But then the girl version, I love hanging out with her, and she's like my best friend. You get me?
So yeah. I feel like me and you, like I feel like I like Cynthia's vibe. Like I feel like Cynthia has a really cool vibe. She's like a very nice aura to her. I'm always about like, how do I feel about people? Like feel around.
You have a nice aura around you. Have you been told that before?
Not to be bragging, but I swear.
I have, yeah. Do you meditate? How do you achieve that?
I feel like it's a lot of like trying to stay present and balance. It's balance. I mean, I'm a Libra, so like that's what I stand for, right?
Yeah.
Like, balance. And I think having a balance in everything in life, it just makes you like feel fulfilled and content, you know?
Yeah.
So I feel like as long as I'm balanced, like I feel good in life. And if I feel good in life, I feel good around people, you know?
Yeah. Are you single? No. Oh my god, you're with somebody?
Are you dating?
We've been together for a year now.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it's been a minute. Because when we went to San Fran. I know. That's how long we haven't hung out in. But when we went to San Fran, I was like talking to this guy. Remember? I don't know if you remember, but me and Brianna were talking about it. But I was just talking to this guy, and I was like, I broke up like a month and then he had a girlfriend, and then we just came back together, you know?
That's the best thing, when you date someone that you already kind of know.
Exactly. Like, I felt like he was my friend, you know?
Oh, a year? That's really cute.
Yeah. It's my longest relationship.
Is it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Like a year, but it's short, but.
What's his sign?
He's a Pisces. Which is unexpected for me. Like, I was not expecting to be with a Pisces, but it worked.
That's cute. Good for you. I was hoping to catch you while you're single.
For real? Because you're just getting in. My bad.
No, it's fine. They already know.
Oh, okay. You mentioned
it. They know, yeah.
Okay. Like, I know I've been with him for a year, but I love being single. Like, I don't want to be single again, but I just know that I love it.
You'd rather be single than in a relationship? I mean, which one do you like better?
Yeah, big time. I mean, I'm a Libra, so I'm always going to be relationship oriented. Yeah. But at the same time, like, when I was single, I had a lot of relationships with friends, you know? Like, I felt fulfilled in that way. But, like,
so many places to go to.
Exactly. It's like, but now, like, I definitely do see myself wanting to be with him, but I understand how nice it is to be single. I don't know, personally.
I haven't really been single, so that's why I feel like this is so new to me.
Okay, so let me help you enjoy it then, because it's fun. It's fun.
I'm ready.
Well, how do you feel right now? Like, you want to stay single, or how are you feeling?
No, I definitely want to stay single. I just want to be single and focus on the things I want to do. I can't imagine opening my heart up again.
Exactly.
And trying to figure out what
Build
you like.
Life, exactly.
I don't care. You know what I mean?
Don't want to go back to life.
Okay, so we're at Hillstone Restaurant. I got the crunch avocado roll and my 42. Cynthia got, what did you get? She got a margarita. And I think it's the shrimp.
Something
shrimp roll, like a shrimp nut roll.
Okay, so before my nail appointment, I wanted to get like an iced drink.
Yes, I forgot to update you guys. So we left the restaurant. I wanted to do my nails. I didn't want her like to wait, and she said she didn't want to wait either. So I'm gonna do my nails, and then we're gonna get together again later and go to. We're gonna like pregame somewhere before we go to this event. So I guess this event is like a weed event, but it's like in a club. It's in a club, and I guess you can smoke in there. And I was like, I'm there. Like, that sounds fun.
Did you just have that? Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm probably right. I'm so freezing.
Yeah. This is who does my nails the best if you're in Phoenix or not in Phoenix.
Nails by Shaky. Yeah. Curious, follow me. Little dab set.
We're gonna have a dab moment.
Yeah. If it gets stuck on it, you could just wipe it on the side of the thing. Yeah. Period.
We got it.
Period.
That's a good
one. Right.
I just did this or this?
We'll start with this one.
This is so cute. Right, I need to do the whole wall. Yay.
I'm trying not to breathe hard. I
know, right? Got done, guys. This is the set. It's so cute. It gives me like super like feminine girly vibes. I love them. And the big butterfly, it's really cute. We're pre-gaming before the event.
Big ass Patron bottle.
We're supposed to pregame at Twin Peaks, but we're kind of rushing it because of my nail appointment. Yeah. Do you like my nails? Aren't they extra?
They're so extra. Cute. Okay, I love them.
I was debating doing like a short, classy moment, but I'm like.
No, I feel like when you're gonna do long nails, they have to be extra.
Yeah,
like,
right.
Add on to them.
Like be dazzled.
You
want
to
go with it? It's fine. Like, I was like, I hope she has powder. I'm like, my fucking forehead's out of control. Yeah, okay, thanks. I usually keep it in my car, but I forgot it. Air Patrol.
Okay. After we take this shot, I'll give you the powder. You can go to the bathroom with it.
Okay. Okay, ready?
You want a little bit of salt?
No, I'm fine.
I'm all that good.
Okay.
Cheers! That was rough, I'm not gonna lie. That was a little smooth, huh?
That was crazy.
That was not that smooth, like.
Look how beautiful this is. We showed up to the event. Chicken parmesan.
The sauce is so good.
And we got spaghetti. Dami, what did you get?
I got a chicken tomato basil.
Chicken pasta. And Lilan got spaghetti too.
The best thing about me is the cheesecake.
I'm so sorry about
that. Oh, it's okay. Thank you.
Did you want a strawberry lemonade?
No, I drink that.
I drink that.
Oh. At a yogurt spot. Which one's this one? This one's the watermelon one.
You want sprinkles?
What did you get, Leah?
I got vanilla and Dutch chocolate.
Those cookies are my favorite. Emma, get these. Well, you don't want these cookies? Yeah?
It's so loaded.
I should have got the chicken lettuce. Anyways, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and let you go. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.